is the Maruti Jimny, which is finally launched in India after a long, long, long wait. There's a mixed reaction towards this car. So in today's video, I'm going to be telling you 4 pros and 4 cons of this Mahindra Thar rival. The biggest con is the size. It's very small. Or in fastbean speak, it's chintu mintu. Gaadi aisi banao ki char log bole ki Ignis is wider. And Ignis is actually wider than the Jimny. And the Ignis is just a hatchback. The length of the Jimny with the spare wheel is identical to the Thar's without a spare wheel. And this car is a 5-door. The Thar is a 3-door. Just imagine how chintu mintu it is. These are the smallest tires ever on an off-road vehicle. Just 15-inch in terms of size. Really small. Thus, it simply doesn't have the road presence of an off-road vehicle. Even the fuel tank is really small at 40 liters. Since I'm talking about fuel, I guess I need to fill the tank up to tell you what the mileage is like. But before that, let me tell you why cars like the Jimny need high-octane fuel. This car is powered by a 1.5-liter engine and thus needs higher-octane fuel for balanced combustion and optimum performance. 95-octane fuel allows the engine to have a higher combustion and prevents engine knocking. That's why I'm filling this car with XP95 petrol at Indian Oil, which promises a cleaner engine with extra premium and the superior performance of a higher octane rating. XP95 offers faster acceleration and improved fuel economy. With its improved engine anti-knock performance, XP95 gives you amplified engine life. With its superior performance, you will notice the difference the moment you fill up. When it comes to feeding this beast, I prefer nothing less than XP95. And that's not all. XP95 is also designed to give you a smoother ride and reduce emissions, making it an environmentally conscious choice for the conscious driver. Do click the link in the description to know more. The mileage I've been getting is 9 to 12 kilometers per liter, which brings me to the second con of this car, the engine. With just 104 horsepower and 134 newton meters of torque, the Jimny is just slow. It simply doesn't have the pulling power of its main rival.
Just does not launch. So low end is okay, mid range is flat, no turbo here, right? And the top end is completely lacking, red lines at around 6300 RPM. So this engine is just not cut out for the Jimny's job, because it just doesn't have the grunt and the punch you would expect or need here. But you know, because the Jimny, you can do all this without any hesitation. That's one big advantage. But I just wish the engine was better. It struggles. It's running on highway tires. But this car is not meant for the highway at all, because it just doesn't have the grunt to climb ghats effortlessly. You really have to ring open the throttle and just pray that this car doesn't struggle while overtaking another slow moving car or fast moving car or whatever car. It doesn't have the grunt of the Thar, unfortunately.
The third con is the price. It starts at Rs 14.98 lakhs and goes all the way till Rs 17.58 lakhs for this variant, which is the top of the line. Obviously, all the prices are on road Mumbai. So yes, it is priced quite optimistically for what is quite a chintu mintu car with a very lackluster engine. We definitely expected a more aggressive pricing from Maruti Suzuki. Maruti charges Rs 1.38 lakhs more for the 4-speed automatic. 4-speed automatic in 2023, that's so ancient. And this automatic gearbox isn't as efficient or fun or fast as a manual. So save that money and get a manual. And the manual is more efficient too, but it's a 5-speed manual in a world where every manual gearbox is now a 6-speed. The fourth con, the water reading capacity, which is just 300 mm, which means you definitely need to get a snorkel for your Jimny if you plan to go off-road. A car this capable with such a low water reading capacity is surprising, because its immediate rival, the Mahindra Thar, has 650 mm of water reading capacity. That is more than double of the Jimny. And I have a bonus con for you, which is none other than the rear seat belt, or rather the rear seat belts, because they're so frustrating. They keep ringing for 60 seconds every time you drive off, because that is the seatbelt alert system. In spite of the fact that no one is sitting behind, it will still continuously ring. There is no weight sensor here, which means that you have to plug the seatbelt even though no one is sitting, which is kind of ridiculous. I mean, what, why and how? Fortunately though, in spite of the drawbacks, there's a lot to like about this chintu mintu Maruti Jimny. Number one pro and the biggest reason to buy the Jimny has to be for its off-road abilities. This is a mountain goat. Ladder frame chassis, solid axle both at the front as well as the rear, Suzuki's all grip pro 4-wheel drive system, low range transfer case, hill descent control, hill start assist. This car has got it all to capture the worst of terrain. In fact, this is what it can do off-road.
I'm right now at Pro Dirt driving this car with full bananas, and trust me, it is just amazing off-road. In spite of a ladder frame chassis, trust me on this car doesn't feel out of place here at all, because body roll is very well contained and the ride is also quite good. Now that is actually the toolkit which is bouncing around, but look at this car go. It just needs better tires, but other than that, it absolutely flies on the worst of roads. That is how good it is off the road. The ride is unbelievably awesome and the steering is a bit lackluster, but look at this. Whoa, baby, I love driving this car. It's an absolute beast of a machine because of its super duper lightweight. Here, no problem. Look at the terrain right ahead. This is a hoot.
And the Jimny is going to retain its off-road abilities because, unlike a certain competitor which has launched a two-wheel drive version of its four-wheel drive off-road vehicle, Maruti Suzuki has no plans to dilute the Jimny's off-road cred, thankfully. Pro number two, practicality. Maruti Suzuki delayed the launch of the Jimny in India because they did not want to give us the three-door model. We get the five-door model, which has an extended wheelbase by 340mm with rear doors, which makes it easy to get in and out of the rear seats. Yes, this car is decently comfortable for four adults with a boot as well, which is small but gets the job done. Now, when compared to its immediate rival, it has got a lot more features like headlight washers, keyless entry, push button start, six airbags, reverse parking camera, and climate control air conditioning as well. The screen is bigger too, which actually is reliable because reliability is a Suzuki trait.
Thanks.
Unlike its immediate rival, whose screen has a mind of its own, if you know what I mean. The third pro has to be the dynamics of the Jimny. Off-road oriented vehicles like the Jimny, Thar and Gurkha are a big compromise when it comes to ride and handling balance. However, the Jimny has the least compromise because the ride quality is fantastic. Vertical movement is very well contained. It does have the lumpiness of a ladder frame chassis, but overall ride is really very good. And body roll is also well contained, which means that you don't feel very nauseous while driving this car. However, the steering has a mind of its own, doesn't have much feel or feedback, and the turning radius is obnoxiously high for a small car like this. However, this is a car which doesn't make you compromise as much as a Thar or a Gurkha when it comes to on-road driving. You can drive it daily and not really complain much.
It does feel great to drive on the road because the ride quality and the comfort levels of the Jimny are just fantastic. Yeah, the steering doesn't have much feel or feedback, so that's a bit of a miss. But otherwise, trust me on this, vertical movement is very well contained here and the ride will surprise you. It just doesn't feel like a body-on-frame platformed car. Yeah, at low speeds, obviously, you have that vertical movement. Other than that, you're not really going to complain. It's phenomenal.
Pro number four has to be the personalization possibilities with the Jimny, because this car is very mod friendly and there are a ton of accessories and parts available for this car, which means that you can make it your own. Heck, if your wallet permits, you can even convert it into a G-Wagon or a Defender as well. Such is what all you can do with this car. And you know, I just noticed that I'm taller than the Jimny right now. It's actually standing on a slant right now. That's the reason I can see the roof completely. But look at the freaking articulation that the Jimny offers. So while the Jimny is far from perfect, I feel it's less of a compromise when compared to its main rivals, the Mahindra Thar and the Force Gurkha. Yes, the engine is quite lazy and the price is a bit optimistic, but this car weighs around 500 kgs lesser than the Mahindra Thar, making it light, nimble and agile. It is a mountain goat. Ride quality is fantastic, it's quite comfortable and is loaded with a lot of features as well when compared to its immediate rivals, of course. Otherwise, I feel it could get a lot more features like a 360 degree parking camera, a heads up display, a sunroof. Okay, I'm being greedy right now.
Oh, easy there, big guy.
But powertrain options are very limited, yet this car is actually worth buying. Only make sure to have some money allocated for modifications, because in stock form, it's not that impressive. However, once you start modifying it, the sky's the limit and you can make your car really stand out. Or rather, you can make your Jimny a G-Wagon or a Defender if you're into those things. I personally am not. If you like this vlog, make sure to give the thumbs up. That's the like button, and also subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to check out IOCL's XP95 high octane fuel by clicking on the top right corner of the screen right now. Bye-bye.